Hello, my friends, and welcome back to Days Gone PS5 run through. It's season 1, episode 5 today. So please join me, won't you? And in today's episode, we need to, well, first we got two major things to do. One is we got to take care of poor Alvarez. We got to go out and cremate her body so the bad guys don't get her and set her to rest proper like. And secondly, we need to finish off Leon's. We gotta find the stash for Copeland. Ooh, what do I see? Oh my. Oh yeah, nice. Yeah, we gotta find where Leon did the stash and take that to Copeland. Alrighty.
One of the camps can use this.
Nice. Good way to start the day. All right, so let's get at this, shall we? I will catch up with you guys in a short. Okay, and of course you see me, you know, coasting down the hill. I know there's a bunch out there that say, you know, it's not really worth it and whatever. I figure, hey man, you know, conserve while you can, and that way if you do get into a pinch, you know, you got that extra tiny little bit of fuel that's going to carry you through, right? Ounce of prevention, pound of cure, man. Opportunity knocks, you know. Oh, speaking of opportunity knocking, what do we have here? All right, let's just see if we got any goodies, shall we? Nope, I will keep my bat, thank you. Nothing here. Nah, door's open, so no go, Joe. Huh. Lunch bag let down, says I. But, that being said, I don't know. I should get... Nope, you know what? I'm not going to... I was going to get going, but I just can't. I got to have a look-see in this camp here. Just see. I mean, there could be, you know, a prime weapon up in there. A sniper rifle. Something, you know. So, it's... like the man says, you know, the only shots you're going to miss for sure are the ones you don't take, yeah? So... Alrighty, let's do a little sneaky peeky and I'll catch up with you in a short, yeah? Alrighty, tippy-toe. I don't think there's anybody here. Pretty sure it looks dead. Anyway. Lunch bag let down, but you know, you never know, right? The one time you don't go looking is the one time you're gonna, you know, miss out on a good opportunity and like that. So we will carry on and we will go. What the heck have we got going here? Oh my, okay, bear with me here. We gotta help this guy. All right, I'll see you in a short. Hold on.
Got you.
Hold on, I'm coming.
You want to die out here? Look, there's a camp that...
Camp? Where? Show me, I'll go.
Peaceful Lake, Mark Copeland, it's safe there.
I was done for. Holy shit! You know? Thank you so much! Oh, man!
Yeah, let them know it was Deacon St. John. They know me. Keep your head down and run!
St. John, this is Copeland. I haven't seen Boozer in a few days. He used to do runs for me, is all. I know you ride with him. Tried to radio him, can't seem to reach him. Well, you see him, you tell him to swing by and say hello to Cope. I would much appreciate it. Copeland out.
Yeah, I'm guessing we're going to get right on that one, eh? Okay, I'm just going to have a quick little look-see around here, see what I can scrounge and whatnot. It's one thing about this game, it behooves you to look around and make sure. Now, I'm pretty sure I'm full on sap. Yeah, I'm full. I can't grab that one. Okay, so, like I say, I just want to have a quick little look-see. And we'll catch up with you in a short, yeah? Just going to do a little sneaking and peeking here. Okay, see you in a bit. Okay, well, that went a little better than I thought. That first one back there, I don't know, I was hitting the wrong button or something like that. I went to swing, nothing happened, and man, they got me good. But on this one, on the nest, I did all right. But yeah, I definitely got to practice my rhythm, man, that's for sure. Okay, what do we got? Jerry can, I can use that. We'll fill up the bike. And I think we'll carry on carrying on. I like that. So how y'all doing today? I hope you're all well. Happy Father's Day to all of you dads, stepdads, granddads, great-granddads, and like that out there. Hope you're having a good one. And yeah, you know, love and light, you guys, love and light, man. Anyway, I'm going to let him do his thing, and I'll catch up with you in a short, yeah? Okay, bye for now. Cemetery now, so we got a little cut scene here, and then we can get on with business, yeah? Okay.
Rest in peace. They can't get you now.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? You're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. And don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
You mean like running around with a box killing dead people and like that? That kind of stupid? Alrighty, let's see what we get up to next, eh? Alrighty, here we go again.
Thank you.
Okay, well, I think I could handle that one better. Sneak it right up while they had the advantage and lost it. What do we got here? There you go. All right, well, moving on. We'll get this onto the bike here and head her out on the road. Like that and like that. Well, I can hear you. Come here. Come on, you can see me. I know you can see me. Come on. That's right. Tasty, tasty. Come here. Come on. Witcha! There you go. All right, got a new skill point. Okay, well, once we get to a relaxing place, we will have to... Oh, pardon me. We'll have to apply that. All right, let's see what the heck that chopper's up to, shall we?
Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
What the hell are they doing out here? Gotta go check them out, see what they're doing. All right, gotta go in quiet.
How you feeling?
Anything right. Else here? Get out of my way. Throw a rock, that ought to distract them. Shit, it's cold.
Heat on in your suit?
Nope, nothing to see here. I'm just a little black rain cloud. You didn't see nothing. You're just paranoid. That's it. You just keep watching that cliff. All right, let's we'll see what these assholes are up to. Yeah, I'll see you in a short here.
We got enough fuel to get back. We're going all over hell and back today.
But fuel is the least of our problems. We're on the ground. Just stay focused.
You getting hungry?
Time now. Seems like a lot of freaks around the grotto.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen so many.
Stay low, well, stay low. Well.
I'll bring the freaks up.
Shit.
How are you doing?
Wonder how long this will take.
After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto,
while,
now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance
here.
And the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson. Your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Didn't you hear me? Over
He's
400 subjects. And these aren't just your
if
regular
O'Brien
run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
Slipping like babies.
And I asked if you were going.
Can't be.
Say I was.
And these subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up
bushes.
A hibernating
I gotta get
freak?
To the bushes.
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was FUBAR from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Secret caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Okay, well, let's make our way back to the bike, shall we? Yeah. Freaking O'Brien. Still alive.
I really hate these assignments.
Yeah, I hear ya. Let me guess. You'd rather be in the Belknap caves than even the freaking shit?
What time is it?
What's wrong with your suit today?
This is taking forever.
I don't know. Forever's a long time.
Okay, now, tippy-toe, tippy-toe, tippy-toe. Gently goes. Alrighty, okay. Is that a nest? Oh, that's a freaking nest. Oh, my. Successful adventure. Yeah, what do you say we take care of this nest and like that and like that. See if we can do it without dying. That might be fun. All right, see you in a bit.
Ah!
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode on a farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Boozer, he's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
Okay, so you see how the knife didn't break there no matter what, and I just would have cut a horde and the parking lot, and the knife did not break.
Boozer, you there?
Yeah, Deke.
I took care of it. Alvarez, I mean.
Thanks, brother. She'd do the same for us.
Yeah, she would have. Deacon out.
Okay, yeah, nothing to see here, just you know, looking for bodies in the dumpster, you know. Okay, bear with me just a second here. I just want to check this cruiser and whatnot. There might be some ammo and whatnot in there, and like that and like that. Okay. Jiggity, 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 jiggity. Oh, schmatz, we're full. Okay, go figure. Alrighty. well. Okay, home again. So we're just gonna nip home here, check in on Boozer, and kind of doctor myself up a little bit, do a little craft and whatnot, wrenching on the bike, just get everything all proper. And then first thing tomorrow, we will head out and go over to Copeland, take Leon's package over to him, and like that and like that. Okay, now, let's go have a look-see and get things going here, shall we?
Let's see. It should work. Scrap.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Black helicopters have been spotted in the skies. You might have seen them. Heard them. Thought you were losing your mind. But you're not. They're real. And they're proof that I was right. We thought Nero died out here like the rest of them. Caving under their own stupidity. But no. Like I said, they've been lying and wait all this time till they can crawl up out of their holes and reclaim this world. But it ain't happening. Not on my watch. And don't go running towards them thinking they're gonna save your ass. Any man wearing a uniform worth a damn died more than 2 years ago. These men, they'll shoot you on sight. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus. Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit. You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy.
Okay, guys. Well, I'm going to call it here, I think. We've had a pretty good day. We got done what we had to. We got Alvarez taken care of, and that was important. And we got the stash from that loser. So, as always, guys, brightest blessings, love and light, eh? Now, go tell somebody you love them, huh? Okay.
Hey, been staying a step ahead of them?
Hey, yeah, barely.
Jack used to say the best alarm clock was the sun shining on chrome.
Jack used to say a lot of stupid shit.